In this mystery solar system question, we're trying to calculate how much a planet accelerates when an asteroid hits it. Remember that Newton's second law tells us that acceleration is related to force and mass, so we'll need to look at both the force the asteroid exerts and the mass of the planet to figure out the answer here. Once again, we're going to follow the math worksheet to solve this problem. The first two boxes ask what you're trying to find and what you know. As with most of these questions, what you're trying to find is simply the title of the problem, the acceleration of the planet. In other words, how much is the planet's motion being changed by the force of an impact? The question also tells you two things about this impact. It tells you the mass of the asteroid and the force of the impact. You should write in the values for both of these in this box. The fact that the force is always the same makes this a much simpler problem than it could be. You don't have to worry about how fast the asteroid is going or how much the planet's gravity is affecting it. The prediction in this question has several parts. First, you need to decide which planet will experience the largest acceleration and which will have the smallest. Remember that the acceleration is the planet's reaction to the impact, so the size of the planet is going to be a big factor here. Also, the force is the same for all of the planets, so you don't have to worry about the asteroid hitting one planet harder than the others. So when making your prediction, decide whether bigger planets will be more or less affected by the impact. The next part of the prediction asks you to decide whether the planets will accelerate a lot or a little. For comparison, an acceleration of 1 meter per second squared is similar to what you might experience in a car stopping at a stoplight. To decide if a planet will accelerate a lot or not, it's a good idea to try comparing the mass of the planet to the mass of the asteroid. You already know the mass of the asteroid. That was given in the problem. You might want to jump ahead and do the unit conversion, turning the planet's mass from Earth masses to kilograms. In general, planets are much larger than asteroids. For example, the Earth is around 10 to the 10th, or 10 billion times bigger than this asteroid. A collision with that big of a mass ratio is sort of like a fly hitting the windshield of a car, with the asteroid being like the fly and the planet being like the car. The last part of the prediction is asking whether the asteroid is accelerated by this impact. That same analogy of a fly hitting a car applies here too, but now you're looking at it from the fly's point of view. How much does its motion change in the impact? That's probably a good estimate of what's going on here. Remember that when you give your predictions, you need to explain why. That's what shows that you have an understanding of what the question is asking and what is physically going on here. Now we can set up the calculation part of the problem. The first step is to write down the formula. Since we're trying to find the acceleration and we know the force being exerted, we'll use the formula that ties those two things together, Newton's second law. We want this in the format that has the acceleration by itself on one side of the equation, so that would be A equals F over M. We already know what the force F is, so the only things we need to look up are the masses. That would be the masses of the planets, including both of the planets we predicted in Part A. Don't forget to give the units. Earth masses. We also already know the mass of the asteroid, so we don't have to look that up. In this problem, we've got several units involved, but only one of those is going to require converting. The force is given in newtons, but remember that a newton is just a kilogram meter per second squared. So really, a newton is just a mass, distance, and time unit combined. The mass of the planets is given in Earth masses, but we've already seen that newtons have a mass unit of kilograms, so we'll need to turn the planet's mass into kilograms to match. Let's try this for the case of a planet with a mass of 15 Earth masses. When we look at the mystery solar system table, we see that one Earth mass is 6 times 10 to the 24th kilograms. So 15 Earth masses times 6 times 10 to the 24th kilograms divided by 1 Earth mass gives 9 times 10 to the 25 kilograms. This planet is significantly larger than the Earth, so the number of kilograms should be more than the Earth's. You'll need to do this conversion for each of the planets you are calculating. Remember that you don't have to convert the asteroid's mass, since it's already given in kilograms. We're finally ready to calculate how much a planet accelerates. We start by listing the formula again, this time with the values of the mass of one of the planets and force included. We'll continue using the 15 Earth mass planet from the previous slide. Also notice that we've written out newtons as kilograms meter per second squared. That will make it easier to keep track of what's happening with the units. At this point, we do what the equation says. Divide the force by the mass. Remember to pay attention to the exponents. It's likely that the exponent on the top of the fraction will be smaller than the exponent at the bottom. That means that when you divide them, the answer should have a negative exponent. Or possibly, your calculator will show it with no exponent, but the value is much less than 1. Either is correct, although it's usually easier to read if you have the exponent in there. Also, since we have kilograms on the top and bottom of the fraction, these cancel out, so the answer is just what's left over from the force units, meters per second squared. So our answer is a very small acceleration. Remember what happens when a car hits a fly? That's what we're seeing here. Also, remember to do the calculation for the asteroid. In that case, the mass is the mass of the asteroid. For the force, remember what Newton's third law of motion says here. The force that the asteroid exerts on the planet has to be the same as the force the planet exerts on the asteroid. So you can use the same force as before. Remember to decide if your results match your prediction and decide if the answer seems reasonable. As usual, there are three possibilities. Either everything matches and the answers are reasonable, or else you have a mistake in either the calculation or the prediction. If everything matches, you should say that. If it seems that the results from the calculations don't look right, then see if you can find the error. It's okay to ask for help if you're not finding it. If it's really too late and you need to turn it in, at least make sure that you say why you think there's something wrong with the result. If the problem is in the prediction, you should explain what you should have predicted and why. But only do this if you're really convinced that your calculations are right and that what they're saying makes physical sense. Once again, if you're not sure, just ask.